Hello people, in this video let us look at cycloplegics and cycloplegia. Okay, so cycloplegics are what? These drugs, they are cycloplegics. And what is cycloplegia? We need to understand. So cycloplegics cause cycloplegia. So this is an ophthalmology topic. So let us see the cycloplegics that you need to know, like cyclopentolate. Okay, cyclopentolate 1%, home atropine you should know, and then 1% atropine you should know. Okay, so these are the three that you are expected to know. These are cycloplegics. Now these cause cycloplegia. So what is that? Let us see. So cycloplegia is paralysis of the ciliary muscle. The ciliary muscle you can see here. So this muscle gets paralyzed, right? So it cannot contract. It's always relaxed. Okay, so that is cycloplegia. So what happens if this muscle is relaxed and it's not working? The lens will always be like this, relaxed. So when it has to look at something like a near object, it wants to look at, right? Let us say a mobile phone, that's better. So a near object, right? It wants to look at some near object. It cannot focus. It cannot accommodate. Okay. So normally what will happen, that is accommodation, so that it can see near objects. Now it cannot contract, and the lens, it cannot accommodate to see the near object, guys. So that is cycloplegia. What is not happening? Accommodation is not going to happen. So what is accommodation? Now we have to understand that. So basically, when the eye is, look at this, ciliary muscles are relaxed, the fibers taut, lens at minimum strength for distant vision. So this is, the ciliary muscle is relaxed. Aram se it is sleeping. Okay. The ciliary muscles are relaxed and the lens at minimum strength. Okay, it said lens is at minimum strength. That's what they are saying here. Now ciliary muscles are contracted. Now the ciliary muscles are contracted. So what happens? The lens rounds to greater strength for close vision. So it is able to, the lens has become round and it is able to focus on the near object. Okay, so that is accommodation. So don't get confused with accommodation reflex. That is also something concerned with near vision only. Okay, so basically, did you understand? So this is accommodation. Now what happens in cycloplegia? In cycloplegia, there is paralysis of ciliary muscle, guys. There is paralysis of ciliary muscle. Okay. So what will happen if there is paralysis of ciliary muscle? There is no accommodation. Okay. So now how is that all this achieved? By giving cycloplegics. Now why do you want to give a cycloplegic to a person? Right? Why do you want them to not have accommodation? That's strange. Why don't you want them to have accommodation? Right? Isn't it a good thing? Yes, we don't want them to have accommodation. That means we want to give them a cycloplegic so that they will undergo cycloplegia. Why? Because if they are having too much of eye pain, so if there is eye pain, then to relieve that spasm of these muscles, they will give cycloplegic so the muscle cannot contract, right? So what and all you should remember, 1% cyclopentolate, 1% atropine, only home atropine has 2%, okay? That's what you have to remember, 1% cyclopentolate, 2% home atropine, 1% atropine. For everything else, you have to look at the details, okay, from this textual matter. Now let us move on. These are not only cycloplegics, they are also mydriatics, okay? They even dilate the pupil. Okay, so these, we saw somewhere that these are usually given in red caps. Okay, so you have studied these in pharmacology. So we are talking about cyclopentolate, home atropine, atropine. Remember these three: cyclopentolate, home atropine, atropine. Okay, how much cyclopentolate? 1%. How much home atropine? 2%. How much atropine? 1%. Okay, let us look at this bottle. Wait, what is there on this bottle? Let's zoom this bottle and see. Is it, what exactly is it and how much percent? This is cyclopentolate, should be 1%. Yes, yes, this is correct. Okay. Now this one shows the action. Cyclopentolate is short acting. Okay. Tropicum, home atropine and atropine. We are concerned with only these three. We will learn cyclopentolate, home atropine, atropine. Atropine has longer duration. The thing about it is you can, as it is having longer duration of action, atropine, you can administer it with less frequency, right? So these and all, cyclopentolate, home atropine, as they are having shorter action, they'll have to be administered quite a few times. You understand, right? Longer acting and short acting. Okay. So how's it going, guys? So far we are reading what today? Cycloplegics. Yes. What do they do? Cycloplegia. Exactly. What is that? They are stopping accommodation. Why are they doing all this? To reduce the pain in the patient, so that if they have some pain, then the spasms, etc., can be stopped. So let us look at the salient features of common cycloplegic and mydriatic drugs. Both they are saying here. So we will start with what? Cyclopentylate. Cyclopentylate 1%, homotropin 2%, atropine 1%. So basically atropine, it is long acting, it is ointment, it is given only when the patient is less than 5 years. Okay, you should understand that. Right? Cyclopentylate 8 to 20 years, homotropin 5 to 8 years. But here what you have to know is atropine basically less than 5 years. They won't give it to adult male especially because it can cause urine retention and atropine is what? It can also cause glaucoma, right? Because it's a mydriatic. Okay? So where exactly have we seen these drugs in the pharmacology classification? They are anti-muscarinic, right? So anti-muscarinic, so these are anti-cholinergic drugs, right? Anti-muscarinic here. And here they are saying that, what else are they saying? That's all. Okay. There are other examples. We are not looking at them because they don't have a great action as cycloplegic. Look at this. What are we concerned about, guys? We are concerned about cyclopentylate, homotropin and atropine. This is all we are concerned, right? Good. So read about these. More information is available here. So basically, these are mydriatics and they also cause enlargement of pupil, dilation of pupil. Let's use the correct word, dilation of pupil. So that is why probably because these people are so sensitive to light, they are asked to wear dark goggles also because they are putting these mydriatics into their eye. So what is happening? What is cycloplegia? Paralysis of accommodation, no accommodation. So what can be the causes of paralysis of accommodation? Need not only be cycloplegics. It can be this one is the drug-induced cycloplegia. There can be some other causes also. Okay. Nerve paralysis and what else they're saying? Paralysis of sphincter pupillae, ciliary muscle, etc. So some other causes can be there, not just drug-induced. So is this clear? How is it going so far, guys? Let's move on. Atropine, look at atropine. Atropine, basically, let's look at the details here of atropine. So we already know it causes mydriasis also, that is dilation of pupil, and it also causes cycloplegia. So accommodation of this lens, lens accommodation won't happen, right? So basically, how does it work? Atropine, guys, what is it? It is as anti-muscarinic. We already saw. So the M receptors, both the places they have told blockade of M3 receptors, blockade of M3 receptors. Okay. So what is being in cycloplegia? We are concerned more about cycloplegia. So what is getting paralyzed? The ciliary muscle is getting paralyzed. So there is loss of accommodation, but it also causes passive mydriasis. Passive mydriasis means it is not active mydriasis. Basically, it causes the paralysis of the constrictor pupillae. So constriction is not able to work. That is why there is dilation of pupil. So this is a passive mydriasis. Okay. Again, M3 receptors. Okay. So this is a, where are we here? This is a passive mydriasis. Atropine is not given to elderly. Why? Because it causes mydriasis and it can increase glaucoma. However, in certain type of glaucoma called as malignant glaucoma, that is PAMS, posterior aqueous misdirected syndrome, they are using atropine. That is a very strange thing. Okay. Ciliary block glaucoma. But just remember, atropine usually not given for glaucoma. Okay. But it is given for malignant glaucoma. Then it is also not given in elderly patients because it causes urine retention, because these people already will have enlarged prostate and they can have urine retention. Over that, if you're giving atropine, which is anticholinergic, it will be anticholinergic means it is not allowing the parasympathetic system. Parasympathetic system wants you to pee. This is not allowing the parasympathetic system. So this guy will not be able to pee even more. So where is atropine given, guys? You already saw it in the chart. It is given for less than 5-year-old children. Okay, so you can see here. Less than 5-year-old, they will give atropine, and that too is ointment. Look at everything, it is dropped, but atropine is ointment. And you don't have to give it repeatedly because it is long acting. So what are they saying here? TDS into 3 days, thrice daily. And look at these are like every 10 minutes, every 15 minutes, this is too much. They are also used to perform retinoscopy. Before retinoscopy, they will be used, but we will come to that, okay? So they are also used, cycloplegics are also used to find out the refractive power of the eye. Okay, so that is also one use, cycloplegics. So this is retinoscopy. Before this, they can give a cycloplegic. So now you tell, what are the two uses of cycloplegics? Cycloplegics, generally, you should know, some pain is there and for that they are giving and before retinoscopy, before finding out the refractive power of the eye. So main thing you have to remember here is pain, to relieve pain, muscle spasm. So cycloplegics are there in prescription for corneal ulcer, corneal interstitial keratitis. Okay. So basically in non-specific treatment, they are giving cycloplegics like atropine, 1% cyclopentolate, 2% homatropine. Here they have written 0.5% homatropine and 1% atropine. So here they have written 0.5% homatropine. Should we focus on this? Here they are writing 2% homatropine. Here they are writing 0.5% homatropine. Okay, let's see how it goes further. For iridocyclitis also they can give cycloplegics. Basically remember all these are painful things, right? They are giving, so what was it before? Corneal ulcer, keratitis, so all inflammations they are giving. Then iridocyclitis also they are giving, so something to do with the iris, right? So they are giving this cycloplegic drugs. Okay, this is again coming under non-specific treatment. So here there is an important term here, cycloplegics should be continued for at least 2 to 3 weeks after the eye becomes quiet. Otherwise, relapse may occur. So you should be continuing the cycloplegics even after the eye becomes proper, at least for 2 to 3 weeks. Okay, are you able to see it? Or it's too, color is not suiting. Look at it here. Now is it clear? So cycloplegics should be continued at least 2 to 3 weeks after the eye becomes quiet, otherwise relapse may occur. They are talking about iridocyclitis here. Okay. So how are these working? They are relieving spasm of the iris sphincter and ciliary muscles. Okay. For ocular lesions like zoster keratitis, iridocyclitis, scleritis, they are also giving these cycloplegics. Chemical burns, they are giving cycloplegic. Atropine may improve the comfort. Okay, what is this one? Post-operative, after cataract operation, they are giving. After cataract operation, they are giving topical cycloplegic Midriac. So, they will give this homatropine. So, that is why these people wear goggles also, I think, because they are having mydriasis. Then, like we told you, to prescribe glasses to find the refractive error of the eye also. So to prescribe glasses, especially in this hypermetropia, they will give cycloplegic before doing retinoscopy. So to total amount of hypermetropia should always be discovered by performing refraction under complete cycloplegia. So they are talking about hypermetropia, that is kind of a long-sightedness, right? In those conditions, if they want to find, they are giving the cycloplegia, so they can do it without the accommodation. So what are the indications for using cycloplegic drugs for retinoscopy? So when you suspect that the accommodation is abnormal or it will hinder the exact retinoscopy. So usually in young children with hypermetropes, they are giving cycloplegics. Not to everybody, but in certain situations before retinoscopy, they think it is better to give cycloplegic. Now there is something called as wet retinoscopy and dry retinoscopy. Wet retinoscopy is when you are performing it after giving a cycloplegic. And once you have performed retinoscopy with cycloplegic, you will have to do some compensation, some adjustment you will have to do. Okay, that's also given here. Here they are talking about strabismus, testing for vision and refractive error. Okay. Refraction should be performed under full cycloplegia, especially in children, even if they have strabismus, okay? Heterophoria, that is latent strabismus, that is what is all this? Squint, okay? For squint, for examining a case of heterophoria, latent strabismus, that is, what is it? Squint eyes, okay? What else is there to read about cycloplegics? Okay, that's all. So let's take a recap. What we have seen in this video, cycloplegics cause cycloplegia. Okay, so what are the cycloplegics you should know? 1% cyclopentolate, 2% homatropine, 1% atropine. 1% atropine is long acting, given only in children less than 5 years. That ointment we are specifying. Others are drops. They will have to be frequently instilled. Okay. And these are also midriacs, that they will dilate the pupil. The classification you have seen, they are anti-muscarinic, right? Short acting, long acting. You saw the salient features of these drops. They are also mydriatics. Cycloplegia means what? It is paralysis of accommodation. Ciliary muscle is paralyzed. So these people will have blur vision. They cannot see near things. What else? Let's see, wait. Atropine, you saw how it does passive mydriasis and cycloplegia. You should not give atropine in elderly. And they should not give because it can increase glaucoma. But in certain type of glaucoma, that is malignant glaucoma, they are telling you should give atropine. So that is weird, right? So you have understood what accommodation is. So what will cycloplegia lead to? Blurring of near vision, photophobia. These people cannot, they are sensitive to light. Why? Because there is mydriasis. Okay, then self-recovery occurs once you give this drug. What else? Moving on. So you will prescribe it Perinol, corneal, interstitial keratitis, iridocyclitis. You will give it in ocular lesions. You will give it for chemical burns. Post-operative management after cataract. Then, as a diagnosis part, they are giving it before retinoscopy, especially for children, hypermetropia if they want to find out. Okay. Strabismus also, to detect strabismus also. So basically all these are test kind of things, not as a curative things, but these are all tests before you check the refraction in retinoscopy before, and then for checking strabismus, that is squint, latent strabismus is specifically, it's called as what? Heterophoria. That's all in this video. We have finished this topic, cycloplegics and cycloplegia. Bye bye.